This is a HeadGum Original.
Great. Is there a song playing right now?
Nice to just vibe this morning.
Yeah, sure. Lubricate your spine.
Yeah.
Episode 101.
Wow.
Woohoo!
We aren't supposed to be doing this. I don't have express written permission from the network. In fact, I was let go. So
tragic.
That's why I thought it'd be fun to just have Cecily and Lucy on, my two good friends,
sure,
to try and build me back up and to do this under the table.
If you know anything about us, that's what our vibe is under the table.
Yeah.
And you can use us for clout anytime.
Yeah.
You guys are very funny LA-based comedians. Cecily, some HeadGum fans might know you from Jeffrey the Dumbass and Review. This is a very special day, though, because it's Lucy Blee's debutee.
It is my debutee.
Yeah. Do you guys want to plug your stuff up top so people can know where to find you?
Absolutely. Sure. Cecily, take it away.
Okay, thrilled to plug. Always. Quick little butt plug. You can catch me on Instagram and TikTok at Cecily Bro, BREAUX. I know, it's so funny that my last name is Bro. And I have it's a show at The Friend called The Bro Show every Wednesday at 8 p.m. Jeffrey has been on it. He's so funny. And what else do I do? Oh, we do a show called Titty Committee, and that's coming up June 2nd, both of our sisters' birthday, wouldn't you know, Gemini season.
Yeah, gorgeous coincidence.
So come to that at El Cid at 8 p.m., and if you want to watch me on TV, you can watch The Dropout.
Holy
shit. Where I mean to Amanda Seyfried. Seyfried.
Sorkled.
Seyfried.
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 Lucy?
My name is Lucy Blihar. I am an actor, writer, and comedian based in Los Angeles. I'm 5'10" and a half.
Good.
I do Titty Committee with Cecily June 2nd. As you heard, I'm just going to repeat it for those of you who are not active listening. I also do social media at Lucy Blee, B-L-E-E, on TikTok.
You're sort of
bleeding
up on TikTok.
I'm bleeding out on TikTok.
She's bleeding out.
I'm bleeding out on TikTok. You can catch me on a bunch of different like web shows that I do with this production company called Pollution. One of them is Conspiracy Central, where I relay misinformation on Facebook video. And
you're an alt-right talking head.
I've been getting some proposals from like middle-aged men who are like, I love what you're telling the truth about the one world government and you're so beautiful. And I'm like, this is simply a paycheck for me, but thank
Lucy,
you.
Lucy, line them up, take them out. I also want to say I'm also an actor and a writer and comedian. I'm sorry I didn't say what I do.
Don't
cut that out. I just thought you should know.
Are you guys going to bring back Sunday school?
We've both been booked and blessed. God bless. It's just been a busy time.
So that was your guys' Titty Committee podcast, the version of the live show that they do at El Cid. And
yes,
I did an episode of that. That's one of the most fun podcasts I've ever guested on.
We had a great time. Our last episode was with Kat Cohen before her special. She's wonderful. Jeffrey, we had so much fun with you.
We were all hungover for that episode.
So hungover.
Oh, yeah. Where were we the night before? Were we all together?
Oh,
the night
we were
before?
Out at the Hollywood Hills. We were at a party in the Hollywood Hills.
Right.
Oh,
we were at
yeah,
that that totes exclusive party.
So exclusive. But you can find those episodes on Spotify and iTunes. We have 15,
there's a
eight?
Lovely backlog.
Yes.
But yeah, to answer your cue, we'll be coming back as soon as one of us gets famous enough for us to actually make money off of it.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's the key.
That's the tea.
That's
major key alert. Don't do recorded radio unless it makes cash. Because it's really, yeah.
It's more work than you would expect.
It is actually more work than you'd expect. But you know what? Let's start this show.
Everybody here.
Please, can we just start it?
Please. Let's get it started in Ha! Monday, May 2nd. We've got a lot to get to, actually. Segments galore. Let's start it off with everybody's Bond of the Week.
Every week
until the next James Bond is cast, we're lobbing up our picks for casting to sort of wax about. Who could be the next 007?
Seven.
007.
The next 007. I'm going to call it right now Mr. Beans.
Mr. Bean?
Mr. Bean. But Mr. Beans is his... cousin.
Mr. Plural Beans.
Yeah, so the same last name but slightly different. That seems less likely.
They're cousins, but it's through marriage. Okay. Yeah, Mr. Bean.
Someone with the last name Beans married into the Bean family.
Yeah. There's the Beans and then there's the Bean.
You're talking about, I think, the lowest probability in marriage history.
IDK. I believe in love. Sorry.
Love is love, even
love
if you're related.
Love sees no last name. Yeah.
My that vote, I think, is going to have to be Harry Styles because we see him cracking into the movie franchise.
Okay, I just
the
sent
movie
this preview.
Franchise. What am I talking about?
What's that? Don't Worry, that preview I just sent you where
oh, yeah,
he's
don't
with
worry,
Florence.
Maybe?
He's oh. gaslighting.
Oh,
he's gaslighting.
Yeah. He could gaslight me any day.
He could he could run me over with a train. Harry.
He could run me over with the train that he is conducting. My vote's Harry Styles. I think Rowan Atkinson obviously could play a very convincing Mr. Bond.
Mm-hmm. Mr. No. Bond?
Yeah.
You're right, I think he could be a good Bond villain. Specifically could be a good Bond villain.
Oh, yeah.
You have the
good
look.
Villain.
You have the lair. Mm-hmm. And you have the layers.
Moi?
The layers.
Yeah.
I would love, okay, actually, let's talk about this for a second. It's my dream to just, like, only play villains.
Yeah, of course.
Well, yeah, you are one.
I do feel like
you.
You're the...
I'm like Scorpio Rising.
Yeah, Scorpio Rising.
I feel like
Rising.
You're Cecily's, like, evil twin.
Wow. And as you know, Cecily's a Gryffindor. I'm a Slytherin.
Of course.
What about you, Jeff?
I'm a Hufflepuff.
I think you're a Slytherin.
I think so, too.
I think you're a Hufflepuff, but you do some shady shit. I think, okay, if you are the Hufflepuff, you're the Hufflepuff that, like, bullied Harry and was like, we hate you. Remember when
I
the Hufflepuffs
Filch,
came from?
The groundskeeper.
This is not how I wanted the show to go.
You're Filch's cat that gets, like, stuck on the
wall.
Oh,
yeah, like Mrs. Wiggins. What's her name?
You're starting it off with a lot of drama right off
Mrs.
the bat.
Wiggins. Mrs. Oh my God, what was her name? God
bless
her.
Norris?
Norris! Yes. Yeah.
You know, sometimes I feel bad when I have my real friends on this show because I'm such a dick on this show, but you just said I'd be, what is it, the groundskeeper, Mr. Filch?
Yeah, Mr.
Professor
Filch.
So it's no holds barred now. Here we go.
All right, let's
my
go.
Bond of the week is John F. Lundgren.
Who?
He's the CEO of Kwikset.
Nope, don't know what that is.
It's the key company. You don't know about Kwikset?
No.
The key company?
No.
Like keys for doors?
You must not know about keys. You must not know about keys. They're better than keyless entry doors. Keys have the power to solve all wars. Baby, you must not know about keys. You must not know about keys. You can get them cut at any Home Depot. So don't you ever for a second get to thinking they're irreplaceable.
Wow.
Yeah.
Is that your sponsor?
What's that?
Is that your sponsor for the day?
I wish.
Kwikset?
No.
Kwikset.
I think John F. could be a good Bond.
John F.
Do you want
to
see this guy? John F. Lundgren.
I do. Can you show us?
Oh. I've already chosen to forget your suggestion.
John F. Lundgren.
My thing with Harry Styles is that he's too recognizable. You need somebody who, you know, nobody knows, like John F. Lundgren.
Oh,
look at the sparkly background for him.
Yeah.
This is him being like, I think I should try something different this year.
Honestly, he has a genuine smile. I think this is an actually happy guy.
Oh. Yeah, but his eyes are saying not a lot. That's all I'm going to say. The eyes aren't giving me a lot of, but that, could be good for a villain.
Yeah, no, he's going to be James.
He's going to be the Bond.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay, that's bold casting on your part, but let's give him a chance. Let's give the kid a shot.
I think casting would like to have a conversation about John F. Lundgren.
Sure. Bring me to the table.
I
want to
see more unknown faces in TV.
Get that man a chance. Give this white man a chance. That's what I've been saying on all my web shows is like, where are the men? Where are they?
Give that white man a chance.
Give him a chance. He's been through enough.
I just realized that my microphone wasn't connected. You haven't been hearing any of these sound effects.
No, that's why we've been wondering why you were dancing to nothing.
But we were going. No, I mean, did any of us say anything? No.
Not a word.
You didn't hear. So you didn't hear the intro song. You didn't hear any of the major key alerts. Major key
alert. I love that song. I mean, I knew the reference, but didn't hear it playing. No.
That's deeply uncomfortable for me.
It is. Well, you should know how held you are that Lucy and I both like had.
We
your
were
back.
Like, let him silently dance.
We were like, okay, he's doing his little
let
dance.
Him do it.
Well, you know what? Let's get into some news of the day. So President Obama last week has called for more scrutiny of tech giants. All right. He's quoted as saying tech companies need to be more transparent about how they operate. All right. Okay. This is at a speech. What'd you say?
I said, okay.
Oh, let me finish. This is at a speech at Stanford University, and he said so much of the conversation around disinformation is focused on what people post. The bigger issue is what content these platforms promote. Let's talk about it. What do you guys think of... What's that?
I was just saying an agreeable... Mm.
Oh, okay.
I was like, let him finish. Taking in the information. Yeah, let him finish.
Oh, my God. Oh, I'm scared.
What
is... What do you think tech companies' roles are with regards to free speech, hate speech, and far-right disinformation? Let's start with Lucy.
Okay. This is where things get a little bit muggy, as we would say in Pittsburgh. That means humid. That means swampy. That means a little bit confusing. You're disoriented. Because if you think about free speech, it's like, yeah, anyone can say any old thing. But then when we're talking about misinformation, look, that's what got Trump elected.
Sure.
Same thing with hate speech. It's like, technically, yeah, that's free speech, but do we allow it? So are you asking me, should tech companies play a role in censorship of hate speech and alt-right misinformation?
Yeah.
Yes. But then we're getting into like the amendments.
My thing
However, yeah. I do think that the amendments are called amendments because they're amendable. And why are we still referring to the Constitution in today's age? Like, what people are like, the Constitution says.
Okay, heard the sound effect that time. Thought I was shot. Always think I'm being shot.
I mean, okay, here's my one argument against the against the Constitution. Because everything else is like sound.
Sure.
But okay, the right to bear arms, when that was written, everyone had like muskets. They didn't have like Glocks and AK-47s.
Yeah.
So like we should amend it as the times they are a change in.
Yeah, that's really good.
So that was my very Libra approach to saying like, I don't know.
My thing is that hate speech isn't free speech because there's a price to pay.
Yep.
That yep was locked and loaded no matter what I said.
Yep.
Yep.
Call her out.
Anyway, Cecily, thoughts on this?
I think, let's be honest, people are weak and they're just, they're not calling it. Like, oh!
I'm sorry, hold for sound. Okay, you're good.
Sorry, my hair got swept all the way back. I lost it. I'm bald now.
And then Lucy, you come in with the G.I. Jane joke.
Yeah, Harry. Oh, right. God.
Which is, I think, that's free speech.
Okay.
That's free speech.
Here's my thought. Here's what I'm going to say. Here's the thing. We all know that hate speech should not be allowed. Like, the whole nuance of, like, oh, the amendments, all that, like, let's be honest. We know what is good and what is bad. What is bad is hate speech. So just fucking call it out and say no more and easy, done. But the thing is that people want to make money. So they're like, oh, well, you know, we got to bring up the Constitution and everyone's like free speech and all that. And it's like, at the end of the day, we all know that these people are evil and bad and are saying bad things that are causing harm. Got Trump elected is like straight up like just propaganda. Like how everyone's like, how did World War II happen? This is how it happened. Like, so this fucking beat. Hell is on fire. Yeah. That's how I feel. I'm like, I mean, everyone, we can talk about it all day, but at the end of the day, we know it's evil and bad and it should be stopped, but they're not going to do it because they're like, oh, they have people who are using their platforms who are, you know, investing in it. So that's what's going to happen.
These were very real answers that I agree with everything both of you guys just said. if Amir was here, which thank God he isn't, because again, I don't even know if this episode's going to go live because I was fired last week.
Sure.
He wouldn't have let you guys treat that with any gravity. So I'm really enjoying this. Let's move on to something a little more lighthearted, but not unrelated. Dating in LA.
Yeah, almost
dating
in
LA,
man.
Let's talk about dating in LA. You guys on the apps?
Are you guys on Field?
Field. Okay, we did learn about this through George's set. So Field is the king.
I was the friend that got him on that
app. You were the friend.
He tried
it
once.
Field?
I was on Field.
What's your kink?
I'm not gonna say.
I was trying to get you to tell me.
Why, like saying that kink? You can only have one.
Quick, what's your one kink?
His kink is playing loud sound effects over women's voices.
Yeah, silencing women.
I love silencing women
with airplane sound effects.
Come up beside it.
Anyway, you guys never are on Field. You guys are both dating people, right?
Yes.
Yeah. I'm casually friends with my boyfriend. It's whatever.
What's that?
Nothing. No, I love him. We're together. Me and my boyfriend met on Hinge, which he was like, let's not tell people we met on Hinge. But I was like, what were we supposed to do?
I thought you met on Thringe.
Thringe. What's Thringe, Jeff?
It's like, it's the app that's meant to be deleted for couples.
Thringe.
I meant to say thruples. You met on Hinge. I didn't know that. I love both of your boyfriends, but specifically Max.
Hey, love Max.
Sorry.
Well, Lucy, here's the thing. Anytime we go out, Jeff goes, hey, Sus, where's Max? Right away. Not even, no question of like, how are you doing? Good to see you. Right away. Couldn't get it out quick enough.
So what's your beef with Eli? Why don't you love Eli?
I just don't know him that
well.
You
love Max. Oh, neither do I. He's elusive.
No, I thought.
Neither do I.
He's like serving some Lucius Malfoy energy.
Oh yeah.
You know.
Yeah, but then sometimes
like,
he's super goofy. Friend.
Oh, he's such a goof. He's such a sweetheart, but he is like the Mr. Darcy of our lives.
Yeah.
Shrouded in mystery.
Sure. Me and Mr. Bingley over here. Just fucking.
Yeah, you are with Mr. Bingley. I think Jeff is kind of a Mr. Bingley too, or maybe a Mr. Wickham.
Oh, you're Mr. Wickham that's like, marry me.
Oh, I don't want to be Mr. Wickham.
Remember when her friend's like, no, it's cool. He has a house.
And he's
like,
he's a homeowner.
He's a homeowner.
I'm 27.
I'm 27. I'm basically dead. I have no money. Dead.
No prospects.
Mr. Wickham.
You know Kira could sing?
No. Really?
Where can we listen to her sing?
Yeah.
She was in, well, Begin Again.
What Never seen that.
Really?
Do you mean atonement?
Oh, atonement.
Atonement. Atonement. Let's not forget young Saoirse Ronan in that movie.
Saoirse Ronan.
Yes, my kink was. My kink is the library scene from that movie.
Where you're not quite sure if they're. I can't remember. I mean, let's be honest, I can't remember, but it wasn't clear to me if she was entered or not in the library.
She was entered.
She was entered.
There's penetration for sure. Dating in LA. Let's do this. Have you guys ever had your version of the library scene from Atonement? And also, what are the spots?
Yes, I have.
What are the spots?
Oh. I have as well. Although I've never seen Atonement, but I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, I actual library, USC library, fight on forever.
Oh my God, that's the stacks. Not even like the fancy library.
No, I went. Of course. Well, there's people everywhere in the fancy library. You have to go down, ground,
sounds like a horrible, like, you know, Roll Tide style sports slogan for a college.
No.
That yep
Don't ruin this for us. Mound down is when you're...
Daddy, chill.
Daddy, chill.
Lucy, your response to Pablo Pascal's viral video made me laugh out loud.
I mean, if any man were to just casually be like, I'm your daddy, I would just be like...
Yeah, like the physical
I would have an epileptic
recoil.
Seizure. But like, did you read that video, like my response as a good response, as a positive response?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Because I think some people were like, yeah, he's disgusting. But I was like, no, this is me absolutely giving my soul over to him.
No, you were floored. Yeah. You were pelvic floored.
I was pelvic floored. and I
major
have...
key alert. Find what brings you, honestly, sexual joy. And follow the path. Yeah,
that's all we have these days.
Follow the yellow bricked up road.
Hey. Yeah,
that's what they say. Which Morphe. How's dating in LA been for you, Jeff?
Dating in LA, it served me well. It's, what's that?
Nothing.
His wistful,
your
like,
immediate,
gaze.
So
immediate
angry.
Regret.
Why did I ask?
No,
just I am getting pussy, yeah.
No.
I don't know what else to say. I spread four things.
Oh, okay.
Joy, truth, libel, and legs.
Oh, God.
Oh, my God.
I'm glad you were fired. This is no longer a safe place. This is not a safe place for you anymore.
You know what? Let's take a break because I can already feel the energy shifting. I want to kind of bring us back. Let's thank some sponsors. We'll be right back. Guys, everybody's talking about fake spring and how difficult it is to dress around this time. But that's because it is. You know, it can be so difficult to find the right outfit in the spring when every day is different and the weather can change at the drop of a hat. Luckily, Faherty makes it way easier. They make the perfect clothes for all seasons. Faherty is a family-run brand making high-quality, timeless clothing with modern design and functionality. It's that kind of effortless style that you want every time you go digging in your closet. That set, that shirt, that dress, that feels like you've had it for years. Maybe it's in a gorgeous print, and maybe it looks vintage, but it fits so well that it feels like it was just made yesterday for you. Well, that's Faherty. I'm really serious, guys, that I'm excited about this sponsorship. It kind of came out of nowhere, but I have been wearing Faherty clothes for, it sounds like a joke, but the better part of a decade. It's been like 5 years. And I don't have that many things from them, but, you know, I wear them all the time and they've lasted the tests of time. There's a lot of other clothing brands that, yeah, are maybe more affordable, but you end up having to buy multiple ones because they wear through, they wear out, they just start feeling nasty. Faherty, my clothes from Faherty feel as good as the day I got them, if not better, because they're high quality. And Faherty's so confident in the quality of their stuff that they have a lifetime guarantee of quality. They'll replace or fix your clothes forever, no matter what. I mean, talk about making it easier to get dressed. I haven't even had to use it in over 5 years because it's just that good, but... lifetime guarantee. Maybe at year 10, I might send it into Faherty. Right now, Faherty is giving HeadGum Podcast listeners 20% off. That's 20% off. That's a big chunk. So just head to FahertyBrand.com and use code What's That at checkout to snag 20% off all your new spring staples. That's code What's That at Faherty, FaHerty Brand.com for 20% off. Thanks, Faherty. Guys, moms are also often one of the people in our lives who still leave voicemails on our phones or call us just to say hi, right? So this Mother's Day, make that next mom call extra special. Spoil your mom with the gift of quality premium wireless audio courtesy of Raycon. Raycon wireless earbuds are a must-have for supermoms, all those masters of multitasking who need to keep their hands free. With Raycons, they can stay entertained listening to their favorite podcast or music, plus take phone calls with Vivid voice technology all hands-free. Raycons are user-friendly for those moms who are just switching to wireless earbuds. Easy to set up, easy to use, and seamless Bluetooth pairing. Plus, they come in a bunch of fun color options, so you can find mom a color that suits her personality and style. With optimized gel tips for the perfect in-ear fit, these earbuds are so comfortable and they will not budge. All right, trust me, she will not have a hard time getting used to them. I mean, moms are sometimes averse to change. But with Raycon, it's going to be easy. And for the mom on the go, Raycons offer 8 hours of playtime and a 32-hour battery life, right? With their compact portable charging case. And they're priced just right. You get quality audio at half the price of other premium audio brands. And Raycon Everyday Earbuds have over 49,000 five-star reviews. Perfectly fitting for a five-star mom, right? Don't take my word for it. But I also love Raycons. They've replaced the other wireless earbud that, you know, I'm sure we all know. Just the same audio quality, if not better, half the price. I lose those things all the time. And if you're going to replace them, Raycon is the way to go. Two for the price of fun in a way. So tell mom how much you love her and make sure she hears it in crystal clear audio quality with Raycon. Go to buyraycon.com/whatsthat to get 15% off your Mother's Day order. Again, that's buyraycon.com/whatsthat. Thanks, Raycon. And we're back. Listen, I think we've all three of us, I think, have done things worthy of an apology, right?
Sure,
right.
Yeah. I'm apologizing all the time.
But sometimes I feel like it gets lost what an apology is actually supposed to be.
Mm-hmm, sure.
I recently saw this article on fatherly.com.
Grailed.
fuck. How to apologize, the 6 steps of the perfect apology. So what I thought we could do is we could all talk about something that we feel like we in the near future need to apologize for, mm-hmm, and then craft on air the perfect apology according to fatherly.com.
I love that.
This picture is from Pinterest, just a woman crying.
A crying woman. She's hurt. She's been hurt by her husband.
Love
means
never having
to say you're sorry. Is there any more worthless a platitude?
Oh.
I want to write for fatherly.com.
How did
freelance.
We get to fatherly? Yeah, they don't even have to pay me. Parenting, play, love and money, gear, health and science. Those are the categories.
Gear.
Wait, how about the article to the side that says, my husband is a good man, but at home he acts like a clueless intern.
Oh no, divorce him.
I truly fear that I'm going to become dumber as I become a dad.
Oh yeah, absolutely. That's what happens.
Yeah, because like all of your life force energy goes into like growing these little kids.
My liquefied brain is leaking out of my nipples.
Chaos. I love this publication. Here we go. Okay. Step one is expression of regret.
Mm-hmm.
Step two is explanation of what went wrong.
Okay.
Step two is explanation of what went wrong. Three is acknowledgement of responsibility. Four, declaration of repentance. Five, offer of repair. Six, request for forgiveness. So,
okay.
Lucy, let's start with you. What's okay. something you feel like you need to apologize for in the next, let's say, 2 weeks?
I really want to genuinely apologize for interrupting you, Jeffrey, on this podcast.
No, and I appreciate that. So let's go.
I want to express, and again, I just did it just now. So I want to express my deep regret for interrupting you. This is your platform. You deserve to be heard, seen, and understood. And it was selfish of me to step over your words just because I could not contain my hysteria and my emotions.
Hysteria, yeah.
I am a woman, so it's hard for me to keep my shit in check. I'm probably going to get my period soon. So that also is something that went wrong. And I apologize for that. I acknowledge my responsibility in remaining quiet the next time you have something to say until you're fully finished with your thought. And I promise to not speak again until spoken to or invited to speak. And I'd like to declare my repentance. I will say 10 Hail Marys and 2 Our Fathers. And I offer to pay for your next 5 car repair bills. That's my offer of repair.
Yep.
And at this time, I would love to humbly request your forgiveness for interrupting you. It will never happen again. I'm truly deeply sorry.
No, and I appreciate it. I mean, I think everything that just said was good. I think it was fair, and I it didn't make me feel deeply uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Cecily?
I would like to express regret for all the ass pictures I'll be posting when I go to Palm Springs this week.
You're always in Palm Springs. I'm sorry to say.
I'm sorry for posting too much of me in a new bathing suit I got, which goes right up the crack. There's no hiding the cheeks. They can't be contained. And so that's what went wrong, is I thought the bathing suit could handle it. The bathing suit cannot handle it.
I don't think this is a good idea, but I feel like you should plug your Instagram now again.
And my Instagram is at Cecily Bro. If you want to see what went wrong, because it went wrong. It went wrong. I posted too many pictures of my porn star level ass. and I take responsibility for what my ass does to people. I take responsibility.
What's for the how craziest thing you've seen your ass do to somebody?
Well, of course, it immediately went to when I was too young and there was an older teacher that said something he should not have said. So let's go somewhere fun. Let's go somewhere fun. Let's go somewhere fun and light. Well, wildest, like, you, like someone said something, or like wildest, like someone did, like, what?
I like to, like, wild is in something, like it caused a ruckus, let's say.
It caused a ruckus.
Your tuchus caused a ruckus.
I could quickly volunteer something that I witnessed when her tuchus caused a ruckus.
We have an eyewitness, and the eyes have it. Let's hear it.
This was on my 27th birthday. We were at a cabin. I was dating someone at the time, and Cecily walked up the stairs in her bikini, and I saw my boyfriend's face melt off of his skull, and he let out an exasperated sigh, and he was like...
Oh.
He was like, Cecily's body. And I was like, you're my boyfriend.
I was fucked up. I honestly was furious for that, because I was like,
we did all get in the hot tub.
And of course we all got in the hot tub. And remember what happened in that hot tub, Lucy? We put peppermint oils in the hot tub and all of our skin burned. Don't recommend it. Don't put essential oils in a hot tub. Okay, so I take responsibility for what my ass does to people, and my declaration of repentance. I mean, I'll hide the cheeks. I'll do what I need to make everyone else comfortable, because it's my responsibility to hide my body. You know, they don't know what they're doing when they see it. They should. Anyway, it's my fault. My offer of repair. I offer to, I don't know if y'all just saw the movie with the gal from Normal People. It's like off-brand Raw, that movie where she's like dating a cannibal. Anyway, in that movie, she gets her ass cut off and carterized and he eats it. So I guess that's the only thing I can do, is to offer my ass and carterize my bottom. And my request, I request everyone's forgiveness. Please, it would really help me to be forgiven.
So far we've silenced women and shamed them for what they wear.
Yeah, well, that's your platform, yeah?
No.
I mean, you have the American flag behind you.
Yeah. No, this is a quilt.
Yeah, I'm seeing.
Yeah, from like colonial, like colonizing America. Yeah,
like Betsy Ross. Betsy Ross's original flag is behind you.
Like, you bought that quilt at Cracker Barrel, right?
Yeah.
No. This is the first time I've been genuinely challenged on this show, and I'm not going to have it.
Okay.
You knew who you invited.
You knew.
Do you have to cauterize your ass, or can you corduroys your ass?
What? Okay. Basically the same thing. No.
I feel like I need to apologize for... I went to New York for a couple of months, just being gone for so long. I know that what's that?
I said, yeah,
you should apologize.
You
for
should
that.
Apologize for that.
I feel like people, I don't know. I feel like I came back to a wreck, you know, emotional, physical. LA's changed. And, you know, the first time I saw y'all, it was like, I could see that there's like a shadow behind your eyes, because like the glint was gone. And so I want to express regret for exploring another city. I want to explain that I didn't mean for it to be a personal affront, really, of any of my friends, including you guys. I want to acknowledge that it was my responsibility for doing a housing swap for me to explore Brooklyn after 7 years in LA. I mean, I'm sorry. I repent by expressing this deep, deep sorrow. How do I repair it? We got to hang out. I think we should do brunch at De Buena Planta.
I just went there.
Okay, then we'll wait a couple weeks until you're craving De Buena.
Until I'm craving like a thick mole at 11 a.m.
I always am.
Every day.
And I request your forgiveness.
Okay, so you're requesting our forgiveness for you having wanderlust and traveling and staying in New York for a couple, 4 months.
Well, when you put it like months. That, it sounds awesome.
I'm sorry that you gave us the pleasure of meeting Annika.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. You guys hung out. I love her.
And I'm sorry that you ever came back.
Yeah. No, we're sorry sure. You came back.
Yeah. Yeah. Me too. Full steam ahead. we have another segment to get to. Do you guys know Jeopardy?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, have you ever played? This is Jeopardy! This is Jeopardy! Mother's Day Edition. it's the same rules as Jeopardy! With the twist. The twist is that it's for actual cash. So every number you see on this board is money that you can make. That I will genuinely Venmo you on this, on the company card, until the fat lady sings. that was the
body
wrong
shaming.
Turn of phrase to do. Body. Yeah. Yes. No, that on this episode especially. Here we go. The categories are mom's tennis partner, Glenn, things to do on Mother's Day, MILFs, which I'm regretting, brunch anyone, and Mother Earth's sex appeal.
Oh,
great. How do we buzz in?
Just say, well,
Roz!
Isn't Jeopardy where it's like you control the board, you do it, and then if you can't answer it, it goes to the other person?
Yes.
Yes, but someone has to buzz first, I think.
Okay. Well, let's start with Lucy because Cecily just asked that question.
Okay, but I buzzed. I literally made a buzz sound.
But Lucy? No questions were asked yet.
No question. This is... A bad
okay.
Start.
Oh right. No, I have to be like, oh, I'll take Mother Earth's sex appeal for 300.
You control
please.
The board. You control the board.
Okay.
Okay. I'll take Mother Earth's sex appeal for 300, please.
Mother Earth's sex appeal for 300. Mother Earth's Adonis belt.
Who is Orion?
That's gonna be incorrect.
Fuck.
Bro.
the equator. The equator.
The equator. The answer we were looking for was, what is India?
Oh,
because it kind of okay. goes.
Oh, yeah. It's cuts. It's
that
cut.
Doesn't
okay.
make any sense. That was stupid.
Okay. Okay.
I thought Cecily's was a brilliant answer.
Okay. Okay.
All right. Cecily controls the board.
Okay, I will take MILFs for 300.
MILFs for 300. A Tony-nominated actor known best for Annie and Sister Act. New pants, please.
Oh, okay. Okay. Hold on. Best known for Annie. And Sister Act has not been turned into a musical, right? Can I ask a question or no? No.
Is it a musical?
No.
Yeah,
is
actually,
it
was turned into a stage musical, I think, but it didn't.
But
survive.
We're talking Sister Act,
the movie.
Okay. Well,
isn't there supposed to be a countdown?
Oh my god!
Yeah, out of
fine.
Time, Lucy.
I also don't know, but I'm going to go with who is Bernadette Peters.
Oh, I mean, I want to give it to you, but the answer we were looking for is who is Lois DeBonzi?
Oh my God.
What?
Whatever. I was like, Carol Burnett is in Sister Act, maybe?
It is Jeopardy. Lucy controls the board.
Okay. Let's go with Brunch Anyone for 200, please.
Brunch Anyone for 200. Clams on the half shell with breadcrumbs and bacon.
What? Is this a dish I'm supposed to be naming?
Yes.
Oh. What is clams on the half shell with breadcrumbs and bacon? What is Mommy Surprise?
Actually, you know what? I'm going to give you that one.
What?
Clams Casino.
Oh my God.
Did you know that, Sess?
Of course not. Of course
not. All right,
Lucy
controls the board.
Wow, he just gave it to me. Let's do...
Because you got it right.
Let's do Mom's Tennis Partner Glenn for 100, please.
Mom's Tennis Partner Glenn for 100. When Dad is away on business. Actually, I think you can buzz in.
How?
Just say buzz.
Buzz.
Yes, Cecily.
Glenn and Mommy will play.
I'll give you that one.
Thank you.
When does Glenn usually come over?
Oh, good.
Cecily controls the board.
Okay, I'm going to go with MILFs for 200.
MILFs for 200. George Costanza's mom. A hot dog.
Buzz.
Yes.
The woman who also voiced the potato head in Toy Story.
Correct. Who is Estelle Harris?
Thank you.
Nice.
Didn't know the name.
Controls the board.
Okay. I'll take brunch for 300.
Brunch anyone for 300. A cupcake who hasn't gotten dressed yet.
Buzz.
Buzz.
Lucy.
A muffin.
Correct.
Yes.
What is a muffin? Lucy controls the board.
Mother Earth sex appeal for 200, please.
Mother Earth sex appeal for 200. The kinkiest border in the world.
Buzz.
Yes.
The border between the United States and Mexico.
Boy.
Cecily?
Boy. The kinkiest border in the world. Okay. I'm thinking...
You're looking for what is Barl?
What is Barl?
It's
what
between Barl? The Netherlands and Belgium, I think.
Why is it kinky?
There's a city on the border where there's like spots that are Belgian and spots that are Netherlanden? Netherlandian.
Oh. See, anyway. I was thinking you were like talking about like mountains and stuff. Like, okay, I'm here for it. Don't ever do that to me again. Never allowed.
All right. Cecily controls the board.
Okay. I'll take Mom's Tennis Partner Glenn for 300.
Mom's Tennis Partner Glenn for 300. No.
Buzz.
Yes.
Okay. Buzz. Glenn and Mom running away together.
Buzz.
Lucy.
Is Dad ever going to come home after this?
We were looking for, does Dad like Glenn? Lucy controls the board.
Let's do things to do on Mother's Day for 300, please.
All right. Shoving your feet into tiny shoes to achieve pediatric profession.
Buzz.
Yes.
Binding. Foot binding.
Correct.
Nice, Sess.
Cecily controls the board.
I know all about that because my mom made me do it. No, never. Let's do... things to do on Mother's Day, 200.
The best way to get some vitamin D.
Buzz. Yeah. Mother's Day sex?
I'll give you that. We were looking for what is sunning your asshole.
Nice.
All right, Cecily?
Let's do MILFs for 100.
A beloved comedian slash actor known best for Golden Girls. I copy and pasted this. and the Mary Tyler Moore Show. Auga.
Buzz?
Lucy.
Who is Betty fucking White?
Correct!
Yes!
You're in control.
Mom's tennis partner, Glenn, for 200, please.
You're being strategic because you're trying to pull ahead.
I gotta pull ahead.
I think he's cooler than my dad, and I tell him that sometimes.
Buzz.
Yeah.
What is son? Fuck.
Buzz.
Yeah.
Who is mom's tennis partner, Glenn?
We were looking for what do you think of Glenn?
Okay, we're asking the kid the question. Okay, I see.
Okay, I see.
Sure.
Okay.
Jeopardy. All
right. It is Jeopardy. Cecily, you control the board.
Let's do things to do on Mother's Day 100.
An ancient ritual involving purposefully getting stung by bees.
Ooh.
Buzz.
Yes.
What is the romantic scene in season 2 of Bridgerton?
I'll give you that one. We're looking for what is apitherapy?
Whoa.
Apitotherapy.
Lucy?
Brunch anyone? For 100, please.
Eggs Benedict with the addition of steamed spinach.
Oh. Ooh.
Buzz?
Buzz.
Lucy?
Healthy Eggs Benedict.
Cecily, what were you going to say? We've never done this, but let me just cross.
Okay. Green eggs and ham.
I'm going to give it to Lucy. It's what is eggs Florentine?
Oh, fuck. I knew
oh,
that.
Is that real?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. It's a tiebreaker.
It's an absolute tie. This is for $900.
Wow.
Cecily, should we split it no matter what happens?
No matter what happens, yes.
It's your cash to do with what you please.
Okay.
Including sending it back to me because I can't afford to give you that. The most vaginal part of the world.
Ooh. Okay. Buzz?
That wasn't supposed to, I wasn't supposed to say correct. Yes. What?
The most vaginal part, the Panama Canal.
That's good, though.
Thank
Buzz.
You.
Yes.
What is Dolphin Cove?
What is that?
Well, it was a documentary, but it's also like, you know, there's a cove, it's wet, it's like inside of a little islet, and then there's all those slippery dolphins are swimming in there, splashing around.
Splash, splash.
I'll give you that. I mean, I was looking for Grand Canyon, but Dolphin Cove is way more sexual.
The Grand Canyon's dry.
And it's pretty like nationalism of you. You're bringing nationalism into this.
Right. Game,
like America.
What's your Venmo? This is so fucked.
It's at Lucy Blee, LucyBlee. And that's for all the listeners out there, too. You can Venmo me at Lucy Blee, LucyBlee. Cecily, half's coming your way.
Thank you so much, Lucy. My Venmo is at Cecily, CECILY-BRO, BREAUX. And you can also Venmo me anytime. I promise you, I'll pay it forward.
Wait, you're joking, Jeffrey.
What?
He actually just Venmo'd me $900.
No, Jeff. Oh,
Cecily, we just made bank. You're kidding, Jeffrey.
Jeff, it's a joke.
This is a joke. I'll send it back. My Venmo balance is so high right now.
Girl.
Stacks on racks.
This was Jeffrey.
Hell yeah. Jeff, this picture.
This Venmo. I can't tell if this is a joke or not. Do I need to send this back?
I really can't afford to give you that money, but I'm a man of my word.
I thought you said it was on the company card.
Well, it's technically not an expense.
We'll follow up after this podcast to see what the real truth is, but I'm keeping it until we're done recording.
Yeah, it's kept. But thank you, Jeff. Okay. Our sweet one.
plugs. What do you guys have going on? What do you want to point the people to? The floor is yours. Let's start with Cecily.
Okay. Well, you can come to my weekly show. I think it might be bi-weekly because
Mama's booking some stuff, which is exciting.
Holy shit.
Hey, commercial. If you want to watch me in a bank commercial, it's coming sometime after I finish shooting this week.
Capital One?
Okay. No. Well, no. It's... I don't even know what it is. God bless, they're putting
me
up.
It's Fifth Third's bank.
It's Fifth Third's bank. thank you. Thank you. If you want to just follow me at Cecily Bro and on TikTok at Cecily Bro, come to my show. It's at The Friend at 8 p.m. I like to book comedians. Have a great time. Come to Lucy and I's show, Titty Committee, June 2nd. We're going to drop some links for the tickets soon. We have a gorgeous lineup. It's a surprise. We won't leak but we sure is. And yeah, if you want to see me on TV, you can watch me on The Dropout. And there's a movie called Destroyer where you see me get killed. So you can watch that too. Oh, and Luce and I have a big night of sketches that we're producing, writing, and starring in. It's May 24th. And it's at the Complex. Yeah, us with Mary Ryan and Ashley Williams have produced it. We have Anisha Jagannathan in there. We have Amon Giddy. We have some great people in, and it's us acting, writing, and we've produced it. So
I'm so excited for that. Those are all very funny people.
We're very excited.
Come on down, 7 p.m. on Tuesday the 24th.
Lucy, please plug. plug, girl.
Oh, my plug. Follow me at Lucy Blee, LucyBlee on TikTok and Instagram. Also follow oversharing.tv. I have a mini web series that I'll be pitching to freaking streaming soon that you should follow along for. Very exciting. Also, you can see me in an upcoming Intel commercial where I am a woman doing business on a windy rooftop deck. What else?
She's a businesswoman.
I'm a businesswoman. I know that I look like one. I act like one. I carry myself that way. I think that's it. Yeah. Come to Titty Committee and, social media. Also Venmo me at Lucy Blee.
Mm-hmm.
That'd be great. Thanks.
And you can follow me on Twitter at Jeff Boyardee on Instagram at Jeffrey James. I want to end off on this. Let's both of you guys say one word as a reason, say one word that justifies this show continuing on, or at the very least this episode being uploaded, because they changed my email login, so I can't even upload it.
Okay.
Us.
Heart.
Was a HeadGum original.